Dr. Michelle Cohen has gotten used to seeing claims she finds misleading about COVID-19, just not from other doctors.
Certainly, I was shocked when I first saw those tweets.
The tweets she finds troublesome are from Ontario Dr. Kulvinder Kaur Gill, like this one, which says, if you have not yet figured out that we don't need a vaccine, you are not paying attention.
To start building, to start fomenting distrust of a vaccine now, before one has even arrived, is quite dangerous. Setting the stage for people to already reject a vaccine.
Gill has also tweeted about hydroxychloroquine as a defense against COVID-19, something the Canadian Pediatric Society says has no significant benefit. That tweet was taken down over the weekend for violating Twitter's rules. She also tweeted, there is absolutely no medical or scientific reason for this prolonged, harmful, and illogical lockdown. It was all too much for this BC family doctor who filed a complaint to the College of Physicians and Surgeons of Ontario, which sets regulatory standards for doctors.
This is a threat to me and my practice and my professional integrity here in British Columbia. It's a threat to my 1,500 patients to have a Canadian licensed physician promoting misinformation that is harmful.
Gill's tweets sparked fierce debate. Some even tagged the regulator. The CPSO doesn't comment on ongoing investigations, but in a statement said, questioning the value of vaccinations or countering public health best practices during COVID-19 represents a risk to the public and is not acceptable behavior. Physicians who are found to be spreading misleading medical information that may bring harm towards patients can face practice restrictions or suspension. Dr. Gill did not respond to CBC News' multiple requests for comment, but on Twitter she has said, there are always opposing views in medicine. There must always be open, constructive, public debate, and the voices of physicians and scientists must never be attacked, censored, or silenced. Katie Nicholson, CBC News, Toronto.